Liverpool is a game on this channel that usually ends up was getting thrashed. What's happening, folks, and welcome to another episode of the Orbit Road to Glory with Watford. If you're excited for this episode, hit the like button down below and subscribe to keep up to date with daily FM content on this channel, both in terms of player reviews and also Let's Play, obviously, as well. So, today we're doing Liverpool first. We've got another game as well after that as well, obviously. The game's off camera. Do you want me to keep showing the goals or not? I mean, I'm fine either way, but I'm looking for feedback, guys. About to narrow down the style and just get some feedback on you, from you guys. So I'll show the games off camera again. We lost to Getafe 1-0, but went through thanks to a 2-0 victory in the home game. And then we lost with Juto 2-2 with Newcastle, a game which I think a draw was a fair result. Two late goals, you can see from Rafa and Asprilla. So it's a fair result, I think, overall. Maybe Newcastle maybe slightly edged it over the more, but you know, it's not terrible. Newcastle United have got a very good team in terms of the money they're spending on it, and we've kind of rested this little slide up here with the league games. We've got a few wins here and there, you know, a couple of wins, one of their, of course, so we've a couple of draws here and there, and it's just kept us just where we should be at this point in time. Today, obviously, Liverpool and Chelsea, we're gonna lose probably, but what we're gonna do, guys, is because I want to show the Europa League, I want to kind of make it, I want to kind of do it the usual style. We're going to do Liverpool and Fenerbahce today, and then we're probably going to do Fenerbahce and Tottenham after that. Obviously, I can always say with European games on my channel, if we get tonked 3 or 4-0, we're out, most likely, that means. So I'll then not show that. So it depends on what happens in this Fenerbahce game and second game today, what I show you. League table, we are currently fine. We're not going to get relegated. We're going to be fine. We will get enough points. Or Palace will drop more points than us. So I think we're going to be fine now. I think we're actually almost secure. I've not done the maths yet, but I think one or two more wins might actually do it. Look at a glancing view there. So Liverpool today at home. I don't expect a victory from this game at all. I don't expect even a good result, really, to be honest with you. I was thinking about, yeah, everyone's not been playing because of the international break. I'm just going to make sure we're marking the correct people here, because this is the thing that I don't like about this game, is that they just seem to reset these things sometime randomly, which is a bit annoying. Salah, good luck there, is marking Salah. Liverpool should beat us. They really should beat us. They are the better team than us. Let's see what happens today. But the third match game is one I really want to win. We could get a trophy this season. I doubt it, though. I still think this team's got the bad performances in it that can come out of nowhere. And in Europa League, in the Europa Conference League, you will get found out with that. I feel Getafe found us out in the second leg. We didn't play well at all in that match. So here we go then, folks. Liverpool at home. We've got good, decent form. We've just got to maintain our focus in key areas. Let's happen today. Hopefully we get a decent result, but it's not the game that we really should be expecting anything from. Davis. Louisa. Davis. Can he find a ball in the box here? Or a pass? Just pass the ball around the corner, mate. There we go. Louisa. Hernandez. Good ball to Trippier. Trippier. Finds a cross to Salah, the far post. Why has he gone to the near post when he's got the open net? Those kind of moments have got to start cutting out our game. Can't get from Salah because of the penalty area. Edwards goal over the bar. That should have been a goal for Salah. I can't believe he's missed that. Gomez. Jota. Good ball. Trippier's through on goal. Good save from the goalkeeper. One thing I will say about this team is the goalkeeper is not a worry for me. I can count on one hand the amount of mistakes he's made, and it's not even the full hand, I don't think, of mistakes, and that's a penalty. That's a penalty. It's always, these are so annoying to stop, because penalty. Okay. So, Salah's going to take a penalty, and here we go. Oh, I guess it's the right way, but Watford nil, Liverpool 1. There's the difference in the game. That open goal we missed it. They get a penalty and they score it. That's the difference in this game so far. Just, oh, he's so close to it. I don't think you got to touch straight, but 1-0 Liverpool, and yeah, here we go. Oh, we've got another highlight straight away here now. Can we get any equaliser? We should have scored with Sarr, though. We really should have done. Louisa, is it a box? It's a shot! See, when that goes in top corner, Sarr scores, and that opportunity there. It's a different game, then, isn't it, possibly? But ball in the box, cleared. Davis in the box quickly if you can't, then highlight. Becker. Just press them a bit better than this. Again, I don't mind managing back. Well done, can I say. I think we're doing all right, actually, in this game, overall. We're just not taking our chances when we get them. A spiller. Nice turn. Good ball at the top. Sarr's through on goal. Can we just one? I mean, what else can I do? I mean, he's thrown goal twice with a great opportunity to score. He missed them both. Boss curls it in. Sarr fixes it on, or he tried to at least. Well, Boss gets... See, I've got to get rid of slow down there. He clears ball. He just slows down and doesn't want to say go for it straight away. Louisa, on the box again. Cleared. I suppose they're there. We are actually, could argue, a better team at the moment to the chances created. But Liverpool will take their chances if they get theirs. Fogging out for Gomez. Chucked in. I think it's clear. Sarr. Lazy. Doesn't work hard enough to get that ball. Chamberlain. Pavard. 2-0. There we go. They score half chances. We miss sitters. Liverpool 2, Watford 0. And I don't think they deserve to be 2-0 up. It should be 2-2. Or at least 2-1, I think, really. Again, Sarr not working hard enough to get the ball. Doesn't see the danger quickly enough there, Ward-Prowse. Again, can I say, and Davis and the wrong positions there, unfortunately. And great shot from Pavard, 2-0 Liverpool. They are just better than us, and we don't take our half chances. Or sitters. Sarr a corner kick, curling the penalty area. Cleared. Louisa got the break on now. Play the ball forward to somebody. Is it Hernandez? Can he score it? Hernandez! We should be free to open this game. We should be free to open this game, but our strikers are shockingly bad at the moment. How we've got a 0.68 XG with those characters that we've had is absolutely very surprising. Obviously, Liverpool's 1.66 is slightly skewed by the fact they've got a penalty, so you're a favourite to score a penalty, aren't you? But we just don't take our chances today. This is the common problem we're having with this team, is they miss simple chances too often, or big moments they don't take the chances that they have. And against Liverpool, you cannot afford it. You've got to score both opportunities. Again, Spiller get down the right hand side here. Playing well today, just can't take a chance at the moment. But on the box to start the far post. If we play like this 9 times out of 10, we'll win most games this season. We've played really well today, in my opinion. Four pass curls in the penalty area. It's cleared to the box. Anel, first time pass. Spiller. Ward-Prowse. Poor pass. Again, just slightly too precise with him. Should we get it clear? Ospina. Long ball down the line. Hernandez. Cleared. Again. Look at the laziness here. Haaland's got the ball here. And look at everyone around him. No one's thought, you know what, I'm going to get the ball off Haaland. So poor. And then Jota's in on goal. I don't know what it is, but our fullbacks, every time they just don't mark people at any time. And it's really frustrating. Is it FM problem or is it my players being rubbish? Our players being rubbish. Because every time I see him make a run, I see my footballers going, oh, okay, he's making a run. They don't mark, ever. I'm going to make changes now, guys. Being Sarko has been absolutely fucking useless today. I'm going to bring Gabriel, the Jarpojo one. I'm also going to bring off Fernandez and... No, I'm not. I'm going to do this. Then I'm going to bring... Hang on. Let's get this right in my head. Gabriel Varane on and Jared Bowen on as well. We're not going to win this game. Rest of four players. And for the next game, against Fenerbahce. Corner for Liverpool. Five post cross. Cleared. And Jappo's got this, I think. Yes, he has. He support. Jab over the top, lads. Louisa. Play it forward. Bowen's not getting that. Again, they either play it completely nowhere near the striker, or they just say it too precise and don't give him a chance to get the ball under control. Ask where from Fikita, and I guess it clear. Again, lazy defending. No one's rushing out to get that ball. Ball needs to work out. Oh, Sarr's through. There goes the foot. Once again, it's not a great run from Sarr. It's a simple run straight past him. I don't understand why they keep doing it. At the same time, they've got to realise the danger is not the guy in the middle, Salah's going to be unmarked, so you all will walk away from him. And I feel like that's the problem. Oh, Trippier, just let him run past you, mate. There's no reason to follow him there. He's beating you. That's another thing again. His decision making in defensive areas is not good enough for this team. And don't care. We can't make changes anyway. No, don't matter. Just continue playing. I feel like decision making as Gomez flicks it on and that's offside. He's got to be offside there, surely. But I feel like the man marking needs to be looked at in terms of they just don't work out what should happen in a unique situation. And also, we need to find a way of making his team better defensively in terms of decision making. They just don't make the right decisions in the final third enough. Liverpool, but it's done again, lads. It's game over here now, isn't it? Chamberlain, Mohamed Salah, and full-time Liverpool too. They don't deserve to win that game by 2-0. I think we deserve at least 2 goals in that game. Should score 2 goals in that game. We just didn't take them enough. Clearly didn't take them. But yeah, I'm going to put on the forum about the man marking because I feel like I want to get an answer to that because I feel like it's a massive flaw in the game where they just don't understand whether... I don't know whether it's the way my players can't understand it or whether it's just man marking is too precise and need to look at that a bit more. I'm just going to forum because... If I understand what they feel man marking should be like, then I can maybe adjust my tactic to accommodate the game. Or if they agree with me that, yeah, we need to look at that maybe a bit more, then great. But I'm going to find out. Right, folks, match number two. And obviously, can't pay him, he's unregistered. So I'm not sure who to play left wing now, because Sarr was absolutely shocking in that last game. I'm thinking of Espella. Is his weak foot good enough, you reckon? No. I mean, Jared Bowen, can he play there? I don't think he deserves to play after those sitters that he missed. So I'm going to bring him out and put Jared Bowen there. I know he won't play well. But Sarr can't play after missing 2 great sitters against Liverpool. There needs to be some consequence for that. So, for the match, this will dictate how the season goes, really, in terms of the end of the season recording. If we do lose this game by a good margin, that could be the end of the realistically the end of the season, really. We'll still show the final 2 game season or something like that, but we'll see what happens today. So got to make it count. Let's see what happens today. We're not scoring goals at the minute. The form looks a lot worse now than it did one episode ago. But if we play against Liverpool, which is the chance that we create, we should do better against Fenerbahce, surely. But let's see what happens, folks. Fenerbahce at home, another good win against the Europe would be nice. Davis, can't take a fucking throw in. If we see a goal from this, I'm done with this team. It's the goal. Keeps coming out from a mistake. Simple throw in. They can't even take a... That is not down to coaching. That's down to just poor performances. How can you not take a throw in properly? Get the ball forward, Trippier. Try ball down the line. Just get rid of it. Because you're going to lose it there anyway. You might as well try and get the ball forward. But once again, this team is... They press in individuals. That's the problem. Look, they're not pressing as a team. And I know, get across to him. But on the box, what a goal that is. I think he's offside though. But once again, they're standing off. And they've got to just try and make players... I think it might be a goal, actually. Given how we're going right now. Goal awarded, yeah. It's all down to, again, just no... Look, it's not marked enough. Not tight enough. Too many people are just not wanting to mark people. Again, Anel, too slow to get across to him. Doesn't stop the cross, gets near him. But on the box, he's slow to react to it. Once again, it's just lazy, slow defending that's causing the problem. They just let people run off them again and again and again. And until we change that, we're going to keep seeing these stupid goals. Half-time, utterly shit. Is what I'd say about that game. I'm going to throw a water bottle at them all. I'm sick and tired of being Mr. Nice Guy to this team anymore. So we're going to go with all-out press, get stuck in, tighter marking, and we're going to go with attacking and go with that and just try and get something going here. Because they're just standing off. Even when they're relatively close to the player, not engaging enough. So it's get stuck in and try and unsettle for the back, Jay. Nothing's happening. So I'm bringing Bowen on the right hand side. I'm bringing on Ismaïla Sarr, and I'm going to up front. us to try and get something going. Right now, we're not going to do anything based on that performance. So, two up front, try and find a goal. This team is on the floor. It just cannot pass, cannot defend, cannot score. And we lose 1-0 to Fenerbahce. And again, it's just down to, once again, poor defensive positioning, poor defensive reactions. Guys, remember, guys are just letting people run off them and not good enough in that game. So we're still in a chance to get through that tie, but it's a long shot, a massive long shot. Where we're playing right now and the games we've got around us now, it's the worst time. Every time we get in a good run of form, it's always before this happens against Liverpool, Chelsea and Tottenham, those kind of games. It's every time. It's so frustrating because you know what's going to happen if you play against bigger teams, they're going to be more likely to beat you. And then you get into that cycle of, oh, we can't win. We need to win. We can't win. We're low on morale. But to get a win, we need to get a win to get morale up. And you can't do that because you get against bigger teams. So we'll come back for Fenerbahce and Tottenham next episode. And we'll just see if we can turn that around in the second leg. But we've got to just book our ideas. If we lose in the quarterfinal, then obviously the next episode will be the final games of the season against Reading and Wolves. So yeah. If you have enjoyed, so I hope you have, hit the like button down below. Subscribe if you're new as well. Catch you all next time. Bye-bye.